We're in the Musée du Louvre, and we're looking at Delacroix's Liberty Leading the People. This is one of the most historically important paintings in this collection.
And it's important to remember, I think, how radical this painting was. It's Republican revolutionary politics were palpable, a little bit perhaps lost to us, I think, today. The painting shows the revolution of 1830 on the streets of Paris, and what we see is a barricade, which was a makeshift blockade.
And remember that Paris at this time was really a medieval city, and so the streets were narrow and they were winding, and it was easy to block off French troops. And they were made of furniture, they were made of wagons, they were made especially of cobblestones, and you can see the cobblestones down in the very foreground.
Over those cobblestones strides a figure who one would not have actually seen on the streets of Paris. So we have this mixture of the real and the unreal, because we have this allegorical figure of Liberty herself carrying the French tricolor flag, which represents equality, fraternity, and liberty, the values of the revolution.
So in the United States, we would recognize this figure as the Statue of Liberty, not a specific individual, but in fact the embodiment or personification of an idea, the idea of freedom.
So it's important to remember here that what's happened is a monarchy had been restored in France that was very politically oppressive, and the revolution in July of 1830 was against that restored King Charles X and brought into power a constitutional monarchy, presumably a king that would be more friendly to the needs of the middle class.
So there were 3 days of beyond protest, of open warfare in the streets of Paris. Charles X actually flees France, and his cousin, Louis-Philippe, is put on the throne. And Delacroix is watching this from his window.
And the violence is really frightening. We have in the foreground dead members of both sides of this fight.
The figure on the left is really brutal. If you look closely, it's clear that he's in his nightshirt. And one of the practices of the repressive government was to go after the opposition in their homes, beat them to death, and drag them into the streets as a reminder, do not do this. There's a very famous domier, Rue Transnunain, that shows a family that has been killed in their bedroom.
And on the right, a member of the other side of the king's forces who's dead or wounded in the foreground.
And that's important because I think that's a reminder that even the royal troops are not invincible.
Liberty strides forward. She's incredibly powerful. And importantly, Delacroix is giving her a kind of realism that was very important, I think, in terms of this message. I think if the figure had been an ancient Greek-looking figure, we would have lost some of the strength of this image. We see her in profile, starkly lit with a kind of Caravaggio-esque lighting, her arm forward with the flag, the other arm carrying the bayonet, striding over the barricade, a figure that leads the people on with this idea of liberty.
So I think I see exactly what you're saying, but I also disagree, because I think that Delacroix is imbuing this figure with all of those very human attributes that we're talking about, all of that sense of leadership and all of the allegorical power that she represents. But at the same time, I think Delacroix is actually very consciously drawing on the ancient tradition. The perfect profile, which is the most noble way of representing the face according to the classical world, remind us of Roman coinage, for instance.
So it's not as if Delacroix looked out of his window and actually saw this. And that's not just because of the allegorical figure of liberty. The figures are carefully composed in the shape of a pyramid. And Delacroix also included very different types of figures intentionally, showing the range of people who participated in the revolution of 1830.
So not only do you have the man wearing the top hat, a member of the bourgeoisie of the middle class, but next to him is a craftsman, a workman in his shirt sleeves, who probably can't afford that nice rifle. But they are together opposing the monarchy.
And so there was a real political message here of the power of the people to overthrow a government. And the government of Louis-Philippe that came into power purchased this painting. But later, this message started to feel a little bit uncomfortable.
A little too radical.
A little too radical. And in fact, the government of Louis-Philippe, although a constitutional monarchy, still only a very small fraction of the French people were able to vote. We're talking about a government that was still favorable only to the interests of real elite. And so the power of the people that we see here in this painting became dangerous, and the painting was taken down and not exhibited again until the revolution of 1848.
Well, look, for instance, distance at the extreme right side of the canvas, and you can make out the two towers of Notre Dame rising above the smoke of battle. And if you look very closely, you can see the tricolor on that symbol of the monarchy. And so this was such a radical image.
Liberty is moving directly into our space, leading the people forward. You can see why this painting ended up going essentially into storage.